Hey guys! So I realize it's been quite a long time since I did my last video. I think this is a recurring pattern for me where I kind of just make a whole bunch of videos in a couple of days and then I'm kind of just not in the YouTube world for days, weeks, even months at a time. I feel that's really weird for me because I really want to be able to just kind of regularly upload videos and regularly keep churning out videos out there for whatever reason, though no one watches them. That's just one of my desires in there, I don't know why. Which goes to say, I feel like, you know, my role model on YouTube would be someone like Grace Helbig, because, you know, she uploads videos 5 days a week, and even though she has themes, I think that's amazing, she has themes for each day, and she's so creative in them. That's what I aspire to do, that kind of commitment to make videos on YouTube all the time. I mean, I can't catch up to that, but that's also like, I'm like, whoa, that's awesome. You got an acting gig, you went all the way to another country, another state, and you're touring, and you're still doing 5 videos a week. Craziness. Or more, because she's also in other projects, and she collaborates with, like, D News and all that. Pretty awesome stuff. But anyway, what's been up with me? I've been really busy. I have a good excuse as to why I haven't been uploading that much. I always try to come up with good excuses, I guess, but I've been really busy. If you guys see my last video, I mentioned that I started graduate school. And I'm majoring in social work, so this is to obtain my MSW Master's in social work. One thing about social work is that if you want to get a degree in social work, internship is mandatory. 21 hours of social work is required to get a degree in social work. And that's because social work is a very hands-on field. It's a helping profession, so we have to have experience in order to get that degree. Just like, you know, if you want to graduate from, like, medical school, you have to go through the residency and stuff like that. Not quite that intense, but similar concept. So internship is required. I don't know about bachelor's degree. When I went to NYU, internship was required, and I feel like that's just because it's NYU. So for my bachelor's in social work, I interned in Chelsea Housing Group, which was primarily focused on preventing homelessness among tenants living in rent-controlled and rent-stabilized apartments. And I also interned in Housing Works, which is an organization that assists people living with HIV and AIDS and also in need of housing assistance, so homeless people who have HIV and AIDS. Those have been primarily the things that I've been interning in. After I graduated from college, I worked as a tutor in a nonprofit organization, and I also worked in a homeless shelter for about a year, or a little more than a year. So that's been my experience so far. This year, I've been placed into an internship with Partnership with Children, which I think is interesting. This placement I would not have expected and would not have guessed to have happened. I told the school counselor that kind of figures out who interns where. You know, we get interviewed. I'm just like, yeah, I don't really have a preference either way. I like to try out new things, but if I'm still gonna be placed in somewhere where I work fighting homelessness or fighting poverty, that's fine too, because I have experience in that, and that's always been my passion. Even though I've recently gotten a little bit disillusioned with the system of helping homeless people. But either way, it's still been always been my passion. But I've been placed in Partnership with Children, which is an agency that places social workers in public schools. So elementary schools, middle schools, high schools primarily. It partners with them, the organization partners with them, and provides them with the social workers. And supervising social workers to provide services to students. These services would be like, you know, counseling, case management, mental health counseling, looking after the emotional and mental well-being of students, and social support for the students. So, you know, in school, students are, all the staff there are primarily focused on the academics, the education, the attendance of students. Well, school social worker would be focused on everything else, pretty much. What's going on with the student? What's going on with the student's family? How can we help? So that's school social work. And I'm placed in a high school currently. It's called Origins High School in Brooklyn. So this is my first foray into the realm of school social work, a field I like never even imagined or considered for myself before. And it's quite an amazing journey so far. I've interned at Origins High School for about a month now. Close to a month, a little over a month maybe. I started like mid-September, so not a month yet, but just about. And I have to say, I think I'm quite enjoying it. I think I could see myself in the future after I graduate as a school social worker. That'd be quite interesting. So what I really like about it is, you know, because I have gotten so disillusioned with the system that serves the homeless, the social work system that tries to fight poverty, there's so much politics involved with that, some of which maybe I'll go over in future videos. But basically, the major problem with those fields is societal values and attitudes, which affect indirectly and directly affect policies. So one big example I can give is when I used to work at a homeless shelter, my least favorite thing to do was drug testing. It's a men's shelter, so I actually have to do it. Clients come in, I give them a cup, I lead them into the bathroom, and they pee, and I watch them pee into a cup. Urine testing, drug testing, right? My least favorite thing to do is one of the most judgmental things you do to me. I have social work values, so that's like just so bothersome to me. But something like that, you know, it's rare to see that kind of, you know, there are laws in place that really come into conflict with social work values. There were a lot of that in like working for the homeless population. With students, I think not as much, because one thing I really like about school social work in particular is because society at large views public education as something that should be provided free of charge to everyone. Everyone pays his taxes for it, and almost everyone, I mean some people are probably going to gripe about it, but almost everyone, American society has come to a point where we agree that's a good thing. You know, kids can't learn on their own, and it should be something that should be provided to them. Didn't always used to be this way, and like the late 19th century, there was a debate about public education, just like how there is a debate in this country right now about healthcare. Whether it's something that, you know, should be provided to all with, you know, or it's something that should be provided only to those who can afford it. That kind of thing. Education was in that sort of debate. Not anymore. I mean, it's a public thing. So the societal values and attitude towards public education is positive. There's no stigma. So that, I think, is what I really like about school social work, because that means there's so many resources to utilize to provide the best kind of services to students, which is great. So I like that aspect a lot. My favorite thing about school social work is that the clients are there in the building with me almost at all times. There is less of an emphasis on outreaching to clients, clients, you know, this is social work jargon, but the students would be considered clients in my case. So I don't have to outreach to students because they're in the building with me, unless their attendance rate is an issue. But then there is a system in place with, you know, the city regulations and all that in order to reach out to those kids who are not coming to school. So I think that's awesome, because in my experience with other social services field and nonprofits, the major issue is outreaching to clients, figuring out, you know, why clients are not receiving the services they're supposed to be eligible for or supposed to be receiving, things like that. Not an issue in school social work, which I think is pretty awesome, and it's really fun working with kids in this capacity. And I can imagine, like, if I was working as a school social worker, it really doesn't even feel like a job. I enjoy it so much that the fact that I will be ended up being paid for it is just like, whoa, that just blows my mind. Which is kind of like my deal with my part-time job. So my part-time job, I'm currently working 2 days a week at local elementary school. And my job is being a teacher's aide or a classroom tutor. So I'm just hanging out with kids, helping them learn stuff. It's so awesome. It's so fun. And I'm paid for it, which is crazy. So it's interesting that I think I'm spoiled in a way, because every job I've ever had, I've always really enjoyed. And I'll probably make a video about how spoiled I am in my job experience history. You know, I've been really spoiled. And there is like a few times where I'm just like, this job, like, it's no longer enjoyable for me. And I quit. Like, I was spoiled enough to have been able to do that in my life. You know, I was never stuck at a minimum wage job going, oh my god, I gotta make money, so I'm doing this work. Never had that experience. And the fact is, the crazy thing is, my part-time job as a tutor, it's an easy job. Like, I just hang out with kids, with, you know, fourth graders, third graders, and I just point them out some things, and I talk with them. I'm getting, like, $14 an hour for that. Like, what? It's easy, it's fun, I don't understand. You know, I can't imagine being, like, a fast food worker and just doing repetitive, pretty grueling work at times, just doing that. Or being in a factory and being paid shit for it and hating the job for it. I mean, that kind of is weird, you know. I love my job, I have fun with it, and I'm surprised I'm paid for it. Which, I say this because tutoring has always been something I volunteered for. When I was in college, trying to get my bachelor's, I tutored as a volunteer in a local Catholic school. Like, it's a Catholic organization, but it is a school. So, has a religious affiliation, but most of the education was secular, which is interesting. But yeah, I volunteer there. I volunteer to tutor in after-school programs of nonprofits, which means I was tutoring without pay, and I was having fun. Now I'm tutoring and having fun. I'm being paid for it. What the hell, right? I don't know. I think that's really cool. Anyway, this is my foray into school social work. I'm really enjoying it so far. And it might actually be something I end up doing in the future as an actual, like, career thing. Don't know how I feel about that entirely. I'm not sure yet. But it's definitely a possibility. One thing that kind of worries me is I feel like it's a comfortable position for me. And the thing that, you know, was bothersome and frustrating with, like, homeless services field or with HIV and AIDS fields was kind of like, it's so challenging and so frustrating, but at the same time, I think I thrived on that. I'm not sure if school social work could have that, but I don't know. I'm learning a lot of new things. The thing with school social work is, you know, group therapy is important, so I'm not experienced with group work. Today, which would be tomorrow for you guys, in my time. Today I co-facilitated a group therapy session for the first time ever, which was cool. I'll probably make a video on that. I'm learning new things. I'm doing new things. This is an avenue of social work or avenue, just work that I never even considered for myself. And I'm surprised I never considered it before. You know, it's quite fun. And hopefully it stays that way, but for the time being, I am super busy. I'm in school every day. I'm in Mondays and Thursdays, I'm in elementary school being a tutor. And Tuesdays and Wednesdays and Fridays, I'm in a high school being a freaking school social work intern. And then Saturdays, I'm in college, graduate school, in lectures and reading assignments and all that. I have 3 classes on Saturdays, man. So the only day I don't have anything school-related is Sunday, which is crazy. So I'm keeping myself busy. I'm still having fun. This week, I hung out with a friend, went to a bar, and got drunk. So that's still going on. But part of the reason why I haven't been making any YouTube videos is because I'm busy again, which is cool. I like being busy. It makes me kind of miss the good old days of being lazy and having fun, but being busy is also good too. But yeah, that's all. That's my update for now. Hopefully I end up making more and more videos. I'll try. Can't promise nothing, but yeah. Take care. Take it easy.